Hello and welcome to Drone Film Guide, the channel where we learn to fly like filmmakers. My name is Stuart Carroll. Now, much as this channel is going well, it will come as a great surprise to you to find out that this is not my house. We are here on a corporate job today. My lovely wife Alina is behind the camera filming me, and we've been doing some fantastic building shots in this afternoon and evening sun here in sunny Scotland. So we're going to have a little chat today about how to make the most of filming buildings. So the first tip for filming buildings is understand your light. Light and shadows. Look at my face, big bright section here, shadow section here. Is that correct, Alina? Is there a shadow section on this side of my face?
Yes.
Oh, that's good to know. Good. Now, very often when you're filming people, you don't really want these shadows. It makes them look a little bit harsh if you have wrinkles that you want to hide. Like myself, for example, you want a nice flat light because you don't want the textures that that creates, the contours and the depth in the shot. However, when we're filming buildings, more often than not, you want to get the best 3D representation that you can of real life on your 2D image on your screen. You have the sun coming down, it creates shadows, and that creates a much more interesting shot. Be it the trees casting shadows in the foreground or the background, or be it on the building itself, we have, let's say, a nicely illuminated front of the building and a darker face on the side of the house. So when you get to the location, take a look up and see where the sun is and see how that's going to factor into your shoot. Okay, so the second thing you want to consider when you're filming buildings is that much as buildings can look very nice, they don't move, so they're not always that interesting. And especially if you're planning on putting more than one shot in, you have to add a little bit of variety into your filming. Now, you can't move the building, you can't move the trees that surround the building, you can't move the grass, so you have to move the camera itself. So take advantage of all the intelligent flight modes, do some point of interest rotations, try and find something to film behind, create some depth in that shot. Again, we're looking for some three-dimensionality. I think that's a word, yeah? Yes, we want to create layers, we want to create depth. Keep that in mind also. The third thing you want to consider is where to stand so that you're not in the shot. Now this house behind us is a lovely massive house, but it's not the biggest building you're ever going to film. So it's fairly easy for us to get behind the camera and still get our nice wide shots of the house. If on the other hand you're filming something utterly ginormous, you might have to walk for a kilometre so that you can stand behind the camera that's on your drone. Now that being said, if you need to, you can actually stand in the shot as long as you stand in the shadows. Take a look at some of these examples, see if you can figure out where we're standing when the shots were taken, and then we'll point an arrow and we'll show you where we actually were standing. Number four, this is our motto. Just because you can fly high doesn't mean that you should. The roofs of buildings, trust me, are not the most interesting ways to represent the building. Flying over a building, pointing down, unless it's got the most fascinating turrets and roofs in the world, are not great either. So keep it low. You know, as I've said in one of the previous points, shift nice and low from behind a tree, create some depth in the shot. Even maybe surprise your audience, start off low and you think that this is being filmed on a ground camera, then take it off and start to point down at the building. And you're like, whoa, you know, that's not a ground camera, that's a drone or a huge crane or something amazing. Try and be creative, try and tell a story with your shot. Just because you can fly high doesn't mean you should. Okay, the fifth point, we'll make this quick because I'm getting cold and every time we're diving around to try and get a bit of extra sun on my face. So the fifth point to think about is your editing. Watch a Hollywood movie. Even the best drone shot in the world probably isn't going to be that long a shot. Long shots can be boring shots, and especially when no matter how nice your house is or how nice the light is, you don't want to sit and watch a 20 second shot of a drone flying backwards and forwards or whatever the case may be. But sometimes you want to cover that kind of distance. So think about some post-production techniques to either speed up your footage so that you can cover more distance in a shorter period of time, or maybe do little speedy up sections in the middle. That's something we do quite a lot. That's quite cool. You'll see that in music videos and adverts and maybe even films as well. So yes, long shots are boring shots more often than not, and keep that in mind when you're structuring your shot and considering your moves. So there you have our five tips for filming buildings. Given how big and inanimate buildings are, you have to work that a little bit harder to make the shots interesting and creative. But when you do, you can really tell a story with the footage. As always, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. We have lots more videos on the way, and we're building a really nice community here of people that are interested in filmmaking with drones. Stay tuned for more content from Drone Film Guides.